Brandon is working on a team project, but is struggling to make progress since they are all working remotely now and don't have the tools to collaborate at the level they need. The team gets together and collectively decide to sign up for a non-IT-approved software that they are sure will solve all of their problems. They can upload their files, edit them, and use all these cool new templates. What could go wrong, right? Welcome to another episode of Once Upon an Attack, a web series by the Splunk Education team in which we learn about common cybersecurity threats and attacks. Today, we will talk about insider threats. An insider threat is the potential for an insider to use their authorized access or understanding of an organization to harm that organization. An insider, in this context, being a person who has been trusted with access or knowledge of an organization's resources, which can include personnel, information, facilities, equipment, networks, and other systems. As you can imagine, insider threats are a delicate subject. In the best-case scenario, an insider threat is unintentional. This type of insider threat comes from accidents, employee mishaps, or unclear security policies. In the worst case, it is intentional. The same people that an organization trusted are the ones that are using that trust to bring everyone else harm. Whether caused by negligence or malice, insider threats should be taken seriously. But what about Brandon's story? Certainly, they chose to use software that is well-established and secure, and they have no malicious intent, they are just trying to do their job. And that may be so, but by choosing non-approved software, they are moving confidential documents to a location that can't be monitored or protected by their own IT and security teams. This is an example of what's known as shadow IT. From using unapproved cloud software to bringing your own Wi-Fi access point for better connection to the office network, shadow IT opens a hole in the carefully crafted security built by security operations and IT teams, and it has been linked with multiple incidents. And this is, unfortunately, what happened with Brandon's team. For a while, it seemed like everything was working fine. They were able to collaborate with each other and even share project updates with their customers and stakeholders. Until one day, Rebecca received a phishing email and submitted her username and password to a credential harvesting site designed to look like their new tool. Because their new tool was not following the organization's security policies, no second-factor authentication was configured, and Rebecca didn't notice a thing. The attacker now had Rebecca's credentials and could access their confidential documents, including internal and external contacts, without the team being aware of any of this. Now imagine, if Rebecca uses the same password for this tool as she does for other corporate tools, this could increase the chances of the attacker gaining access to the corporate network too. Do you see the problem now? According to Splunk's 2023 State of Security report, insider attacks are still a concern and a common occurrence. Being that their nature makes them hard to identify and their potential impact can be huge, collaboration and awareness amongst users and security professionals is key, as well as having the right tools to detect it. Now let's take a look at this from the perspective of the security operations and IT teams of this organization. How did they find out about this issue? Insider threat activity can easily hide behind legitimate user tasks, but there are some unusual behaviors that can give it away, especially if more than one anomaly occurs. And this is where concepts like user and entity behavior analytics, or UEBA, and risk-based alerting, or RBA, can be really helpful. For example, an individual user starting a session from an unexpected location may just be someone working remotely. A user account trying to use an application that is not relevant to their profile, or trying to access a folder with critical private data that is way beyond their scope, could be suspicious, but it could also be an honest mistake. If this account starts to download multiple files to a removable drive or to a personal computer, well, individually, each of these actions may be normal, a special situation, or a mistake. But when we add them together, they should definitely raise alarms. A security analyst who is handling hundreds of events may not make this connection right away. But well-configured security tools can definitely help bring situations like this one to the surface, just like it did for Brandon's organization. After seeing some strange behaviors and digging a little deeper, the security operations team flagged traffic to the non-approved application in their proxy logs and started a conversation with Brandon's team. Finding out that the situation was a little worse than they imagined, they immediately started incident response activities. Good luck with that, my friends. To learn more about these types of attacks and how Splunk can support your efforts against them, visit the links in the description. For getting started guides and product tips, please visit Splunk Lantern. We also suggest you check out the documentation, watch additional videos on the Splunk How-To channel, and register for courses from Splunk Education. Once Upon an Attack was brought to you as part of our Blue Team Academy Cybersecurity Defense Analyst Program. Thanks for watching!